Hello friends, today we are going to understand one of the important topic of research methodology, that is sampling error. There are two types of errors, sampling and non-sampling errors. Following types of errors we are going to study in detail with different examples. First, let us understand the meaning of sampling errors. A sampling error is a statistical tool that occurs when an analyst does not select a sample that represents the entire population of data. As a result, the result found in the sample do not represent the result that would be obtained from the entire population. So now, let us understand the types of sampling errors in detail. Friends, I request you to subscribe to my channel if you like my video and do not forget to like, comment and press bell icon so that you can get all my updates. Category A, sampling error. We are going to understand two types of sampling errors, bias error and unbiased error. Number 1, bias error. It arises from any bias in the selection of the sample. For example, during admitting patients, some patients are less or more likely to enter the study than others. Such a sample would not be representative of the population in which this research is done. It may also arise due to faulty collection of data and bias in the analysis. For example, salespeople updating CRM data rarely want to point to themselves as to why a deal was lost. By being more thoughtful about the source of data, you can reduce the impact of bias. Point number 2, unbiased error. Unbiased error are those errors that arise not because of personal judgment but because of the problem in the determining samples. That is, difference between the items that are included for the sampling purpose and items that are not included. For example, we prepare cheat of 50 students with a 25-25 girl-boy ratio. Now, we have to select 20 students. And when we pick 20 cheats randomly, it contains names of only boy or only girls. It creates an error, but it is unintentional. Category B, non-sampling error. The non-sampling errors refers to an error that arises from the result of data collection, which causes the data to differ from the true values. Following types of non-sampling errors we are going to study in detail. Number 1, design error. When we are designing research, the researcher can make many mistakes. The following design error made by researcher are: Number 1, selection error. It occurs when sample obtained from non-probability sample is not representative of population. For example, if mall interviewer avoids interviewing people with children, he is including selection error. Number 2, population specification error. It occurs when inappropriate population is chosen from which data is to be obtained. For example, study for dog food brand selected people having cats as pets will have population specification error. Number 3, measurement error. It is the difference between information sought by the researcher and information generated by researcher. For example, if individual income is sought but question word are annual household income, measurement error is induced. Number 4, data analysis error. This error can occur when data from questionnaire are coded, edited, analyzed or interpreted. For example, incorrect coding or wrong use of statistical analysis procedure. Number 5, sampling frame error. It occurs when sample is drawn from inaccurate sample frame. For example, researcher interested in finding why people prefer McDonald's selected sample from list of customer of US pizza. Second type of non-sampling error is response error. It occurs when respondent provides inaccurate answer to question. This can happen due to respondents failing to understand the question or maybe due to fatigue, boredom, anxiety, distraction, etc. It can also occur when respondent is unwilling or embarrassed to answer a sensitive question and provides inaccurate answers. Number 3, non-response error. Non-response error can exist when an obtained sample differs from the original selected sample. These may occur because either the potential respondent was not contacted or they refused to respond. The key factor is the absence of data rather than inaccurate data. For example, in telephone survey, some respondents are inaccessible because they are not at home for the initial call or callbacks. Others have moved or are away from home for the period of the survey. Number 4. Administrative error. The result of improper administration or execution of the research task is called an administrative error. Administrative errors are caused by carelessness, confusion, neglect, omission, or any other blunder. Four types of administrative error are data processing error, sample selection error, interviewer error, and interviewer cheating. Number 1. Data processing error. Processing data by computer, like any arithmetic or procedure process, is subject to error because data must be edited, coded, and entered in the computer by people. The accuracy of data process by computer depend on correct data entry and programming. Data processing error can be minimized by establishing careful procedure of verifying each step in the data processing stage. Number 2. Sample selection error. Sample selection error is systematic error that result in an unrepresentative sample because of an error in either the sample design or the execution of the sampling procedure. For example, a form that select its sample from the phone book will have some systematic error because those people with only cell phones or with unlisted numbers are not included. Number 3. Interviewer error. Interviewer error is introduced when interviewers record answer but check the wrong response or are unable to write fast enough to record answers. Also, selective perception may cause interviewer to misrecord data that do not support their own attitudes and opinions. Number 4. Interviewer cheating. Interviewer cheating occurs when an interviewer intentionally changes entire questionnaires or fill in answer to questions that have been intentionally skipped. Some interviewers cheat to finish an interview as quickly as possible or to avoid questions about sensitive topics. So friends, these are the total types of errors included in my video. I hope this helped you in clarifying all concepts. Thank you for watching my video.